In the wake of World War II, Italy faced the immense challenge of rebuilding its shattered economy. Amidst this struggle, and with limited funds, the Aermacchi Aviation Company developed the MB-326 jet trainer, a one-stop shop for training all the Italian pilots of the late 20th century. Sleek and versatile, this low-wing, all-metal jet came with very simplified controls and avionics, and featured a tandem cockpit under a bubble canopy, providing pilots with unparalleled visibility. But the MB-326 was not just a trainer. If adjusted, it could very well compete with other jet engine models of the era. With the capability of carrying a few 250 or 550-pound bombs, 68mm rocket launchers, and most importantly, powerful twin 30mm autocannons with 300 rounds, its firepower was nothing short of impressive for the over 10 nations who acquired it. During a dramatic showdown with Soviet-backed forces, the MB-326 proved its might by taking down not one, but two Sukhoi Su-24 tactical bombers, completing its transformation from a humble trainer into a powerful striker. During the 1950s, countries around the world began to develop and operate compact jet-powered trainer aircraft that matched the performance of frontline operational models, instead of the common tradition of starting training newbie pilots in piston-engined aircraft and then transitioning into them. Recognizing these creations' potential, often two-seat adaptations of existing models, results included the American Cessna T-37 Tweet, the British Jet Provost, French Foga Magistère, the Czechoslovakian Aero L-29, and surprisingly, the Italian-made Aermacchi MB-326. After World War II, the nation spent several years rebuilding its economy, and the financial limitations meant there were not enough funds to allocate to create state-of-the-art combat aircraft to compete with all the new supersonic interceptors and bombers. Knowing this, the aviation company Aermacchi's executives decided to focus on producing light fighters and training aircraft instead. The MB-326 project began with a team led by Italian aeronautical engineer Ermanno Bazzocchi, Aermacchi's technical director and chief engineer, who wanted a simple aircraft, cheap to construct and maintain. To this end, he considered many configurations before choosing a single-engine design, with a robust airframe and light all-metal structure design for their trainer. In 1954, Bazzocchi made initial proposals to the Italian Air Ministry, which managed the administration and regulation of military aviation, including developing and procuring aircraft. The Italian Air Force, interested in replacing its existing fleet, soon took notice, and the Aermacchi internal jet trainer project quickly became a strong contender in a new competition to select the aircraft that would teach pilots all over the country. The proposed model, the MB-326 design, underwent several modifications, and by 1956, the Air Force officially approved the project and requested the production of two prototypes. On December 10, 1957, the first prototype performed its maiden flight, piloted by Macchi's chief test pilot, Guido Carestiato. The MB-326 project demonstrated highly favorable flight characteristics during its flight test program, but required a more powerful engine. In the late 1950s, Italian Air Force top officials issued an initial order of 50 production MB-326s from Macchi, followed by a further 100. This sizable commitment signified a major step in the program. The finished project would remain within Italian service for well over two decades. As finished, the Aermacchi MB-326 jet trainer was a low-wing, all-metal monoplane with a wingspan of 34.6 feet and a length of 35 feet. The aircraft was powered by one Rolls-Royce Viper non-afterburning turbojet engine. The 11 model powered initial production aircraft, capable of generating up to 2,500 pounds of thrust. It was later upgraded, bringing it up to a maximum speed of approximately 508 miles per hour and a service ceiling of 44,900 feet. The jet was developed during a period in which a single type of aircraft that could perform both elementary and advanced training all the way through to a near combat-ready standard was considered by many air forces to be the ultimate training method. To this end, the Aermacchi engineering team designed the MB-326 as a refined but simple aircraft, capable of training pilots from all levels, and capable of a high range of use, minimized service and maintenance, and in addition to all these, secondary attack capabilities. On board, the aircraft systems were designed to be easy to access and remove, with several elements intentionally made interchangeable. Perfect for training, the MB-326 featured a tandem cockpit configuration, creating a slimmer fuselage compared to the usual side-by-side arrangement. It was covered by a bubble canopy, offering excellent external visibility. Because the cockpit was also pressurized, high-altitude flight was beneficial for aerobatic and navigational training, and improved fuel efficiency for long-distance flights also became available for the model. In addition to being very easy to fly, the MB-326's build carefully considered the safety of new pilots and their teachers, even including new ejection seats. In February 1962, the Aermacchi MB-326 formally entered service with the Italian Air Force, quickly replacing the aging North American T-6 Texan trainers. The MB-326 allowed pilots to achieve proficiency within 130 hours, compared to the 210 hours required with the older T-6. However, operational experience with the type soon demonstrated that the advantages of possessing just one type for all kinds of lessons were usually outweighed by the disadvantages, namely the operating cost of a large all-jet-powered training fleet. As such, most operators switched to operating the MB-326 in conjunction with a cheaper piston engine model for basic training purposes. Still, in the years to come, the MB-326, a well-made and sturdy jet aircraft, found its main role as a lead-in trainer to prepare pilots for transition to very high-performance fighter aircraft records and other advanced flying techniques. Within this role, but also because of its potential as a possible fighter, the model became a favorite of the Air Force and established itself as one of Italy's most famous aircraft among its contemporaries. This Italian rarity was also recognized around the world for breaking multiple world records. The most notable occurred in August 1961, when pilot Guido Carestiano set an altitude record for the type, reaching 50,816 feet. Pilot Massimo Ralli also set several records while flying the MB-326, including climb endurance and speed records, which garnered significant publicity for the aircraft, especially from foreign eyes looking into acquiring it. Further, its maneuverability was frequently demonstrated at air shows. Its only real competition was Italy's first jet, the Fiat G80. Despite being more powerful than the Aermacchi, it was also heavier, larger, and more expensive, and thus failed to find a market. While the MB-326 was Italy's second jet, it reached its full potential internationally. The introduction of the MB-326A ground attack model, with six underwing attachments for gun or rocket pods, bombs, or other weapons, cemented its entry into the global arena. Building on its success, the MB-326 found new roles internationally, notably becoming a vital asset in South African operations. In 1964, the South African government acquired this renowned jet trainer, receiving 40 Italian-built models, and a license to build 125 locally, renamed the Impala Mark I. These jets were designated for both training and combat roles. By the 1970s, an additional 78 Impala Mark II, a single-seat version equipped with French armament and advanced South African electronic countermeasures, were also produced locally. The South African Defense Force deployed these during campaigns against the armed forces that sought the liberation of Angola and Cuban expeditionary troops between 1975 and 1989. This conflict, known as the Namibian War of Independence or the Angolan Bush War, saw the South African Defense Forces striving to halt communist expansion and maintain control over Namibia. In actual warfare, the Impala design had several advantages over more expensive supersonic jets. While it was slower, it could take off from relatively primitive airfields in rural areas, giving the South African Air Force an edge during conflicts. Most importantly, if slightly adjusted, it could become a swift and effective striker. For its combat debut, the South African Air Force armed the Impala with up to six 250-pound or four 550-pound bombs. The main armament consisted of 68mm rocket launchers and two 30mm autocannons in underwing pods. With 300 rounds, these cannons provided a significant boost to firepower compared to the earlier two-seat version. At the height of its deployment, six squadrons were equipped with the Impala Mark II during the 1970s and 80s. During this time, they were used as interceptors, facing off against Soviet-designed jets. During a crucial phase of the ground war, the attacking Angolan and Cuban troops found themselves running out of supplies after being blockaded by the South African Air Force. Preventing aircraft from resupplying these besieged men, the service deployed Impalas with a clear mission: disrupt and destroy all helicopters carrying provisions. In 1985, the single-seat Impala Mark IIs took to the skies, embarking on daring missions where they shot down a total of six Mi-8 and Mi-24 helicopters. Sometimes armed with powerful air-to-air missiles for self-defense, the models operated at extreme ranges, flying very low, and only climbed when helicopters were spotted at medium altitudes. After each strike, the Impalas dove back to a low level, skillfully evading enemy MiGs that prowled the skies above. In one dramatic encounter, the Impalas pounced on their prey, shooting down two Sukhoi Su-24 tactical bombers as they escorted Mi-17 helicopters. The Mikoyan-Grievich MiG-21 supersonic jet fighters assigned to protect them flew too high to even react in time. Days later, the Impala struck again with surgical precision, downing another two Mi-24s and two Mi-17s, showcasing their effectiveness. According to former South African Air Force elements, everyone who served during the Bush War can recall the brave pilots waving as they flew inverted over the watchtowers on the return journey after their very successful sortie. During the South African Border War, only a single Impala was downed by an SA-7 surface-to-air missile, while another returned with an unexploded missile lodged in its exhaust. Overall, the South African Air Force operated 62 MB-326s, 125 Impala Mark 1s, and 73 Impala Mark 2s across seven squadrons, the 85th Combat Flying School, and the Silver Falcon's aerobatic display team. In August 1965, the Aermacchi MB-326 was selected as the Royal Australian Air Force's new training aircraft. An initial order of 75 aircraft was increased to 87, and in July 1969, the RAN added an extra 10 models, bringing the total to 97. Australia's first Mach-E was delivered in October 1968. The first 20 were assembled from Italian components, while the remaining had a much higher Australian content. The last was delivered in late 1972. The Mach-E was a delight to fly, and quickly proved to be a highly capable advanced trainer, starting with the Central Flying School at East Sale in Victoria. The Mach-E came with two sizes of wingtip tanks, 30-gallon ones for training and 70-gallon big tippers for ferrying. Due to Australia's vast land, the latter became the norm. Within Australia, the Mach-E was featured in several aerobatic teams. The most popular, the Roulettes, became Australia's best-known display team, operating the Mach-E for nearly 20 years. The models were also delivered to another, much more advanced piloting unit. Beginning in 1989, the Mach-E began to be replaced, and by the early 1990s, fatigue issues and G limits further reduced their numbers. The BAE Systems Hawk eventually replaced the Mach-E, with its last public appearance at the 2001 Australian International Air Show. Despite its attributes, the Italian-made MB-326 failed to impress other NATO countries, who sparsely adopted it into their air forces. However, many smaller nations did, in addition to Australia and South Africa, in more than 10 countries. In terms of numbers, Brazil was the main customer, with a total of 166 models, called the AT-26 Cervantes. The Mach-E MB-326 even served during the Falklands War. Various models from different variants were part of the Argentine Navy's Escuadrilla de Ataque in 1982 during the conflict, deployed to bases along the Argentine coast immediately following the invasion, but soon after returned to their base. Additionally, the MB-326 saw considerable use as a frontline combat aircraft in regional conflicts, including those in Tunisia and Ghana. Overall, this made the MB-326 the most produced post-World War II Italian military aircraft. During a production run of nearly 25 years, 776 were built, 502 of them under license. This advanced jet trainer has since become a milestone in Italy's resurgence in the aviation industry.